from the historic Loretto Abbey Chapel. With the kind cooperation of the Toronto Catholic District School Board, the National Catholic Broadcasting Council presents the Daily TV Mass.
Welcome to the celebration of the Daily TV Mass. I'm Father Hank Van Mail. The televising of this Mass is made possible by the contribution from an anonymous donor from Etobicoke, Ontario. This Mass is offered for the deceased relatives and friends and for good health of family and friends. Our thanks to our donors for the gift of the televising of this Mass to the faithful of Canada and around the world. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And
as we have placed ourselves before the Lord on this memorial of Saint Stanislaw, 11th century martyr, knowing that we are weak just like he is, knowing that we receive all courage from God, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, for whose honor the Bishop Saint Stanislaw fell beneath the sword of his persecutors, grant, we pray, that we may persevere strong in faith even until death. Through our Lord, Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the temple police had brought the apostles from preaching in the temple, they had them stand before the council. The high priest questioned them, saying, "We gave you strict orders not to teach in this name. Yet here you have filled Jerusalem with your teaching, and you are determined to bring this man's blood on us." But Peter and the apostles answered, "We must obey God rather than any human authority. The God of our ancestors raised up Jesus, whom you had killed by hanging him on a tree. God exalted him at his right hand as leader and savior, that he might give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sins. And we are witnesses to these things, and so is the Holy Spirit, whom God has given to those who obey him." When the members of the council heard this, they were enraged and wanted to kill them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Continually be in my mouth. My soul makes its boast in the Lord. Let the humble hear and be glad. The Lord hears the cry of the poor. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he answered me, and delivered me from all my fears. The Lord hears the cry of the poor. look to him and be radiant, so your faces shall never be ashamed. This poor soul cried and was heard by the Lord, and was saved from every trouble. The Lord hears the cry of the poor. Alleluia. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. God loved the world so much, he gave us his only Son, that all who believe in him might have eternal life. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
John the Baptist said to the disciples, "The one who comes from above is above all. The one who is of the earth belongs to the earth and speaks about earthly things. The one who comes from heaven is above all. He testified to what he had seen and heard, yet no one accepts his testimony. Whoever had accepted his testimony has certified this, that God is true. He whom God has sent speaks the words of God, for he gives the Spirit without measure. The Father loves the Son and has placed all things in his hands. Whoever believes in the Son has eternal life. Whoever disobeys the Son will not see life, but must endure God's wrath." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This scripture passage is kind of a little bit of an appendix, and we have to kind of look at it, read before it, and what is behind it. And so this is John the Baptist is speaking. And actually in the previous passage, just before this, he ends with that's Jesus, must increase. And John says about him that he must decrease. And this is really our life journey as Christians. We must decrease, God must increase. And that's a lifelong story, of course. And we have to work at it daily. I would think most of us have to work daily on it, because our little egos who like to try to take control of things are usually in the way. And so this is the road to humility. And of course, when you reach humility and you say you have humility, you're in a pride camp again, and you're part of the earthly material world again, who wants to raise ourselves up and say that we're important or that we're someone. And so this is this battle we're fighting all our lives, I would say. And so again, in this Easter season, it's good to look at how much, in what extent am I stuck in a material world, and to what extent am I in a spiritual world. and which way am I moving? And so this fits in quite nice with today's Saint Stanislaw. Saint Stanislaw, who had a lot of courage, and it reminds me actually of Acts, the first reading of Acts, where the apostles are in front of the Jewish leadership after they miraculously were released from prison by an angel, and they're preaching in the temple. And so they're arrested. Of course, we've been following that all week. And tomorrow, of course, we have the passage that we have the Pharisee Gamaliel trying to bring some sense to it. But the apostles are in front of the Jewish leadership, and they have a lot of courage. They have a lot of courage to speak up, to speak actually as equals to them. The disciples who are really just nobodies in that world, they speak equally. And if we follow God, not your rules. And so this also with the Saint Stanislaw, who was martyred in 1079, so that's 1,000 years ago basically, by King Boleslaw II, who was called actually the Generous. Well, he was not so generous when he murdered Stanislaw, but he was called the Generous because he was built many churches and monasteries and so on. And so he was known as a very generous king. But as it usually goes in these things, he builds a lot of these monasteries and starts up these things, but then he wants to have control, the material world. He does not want to back off. And so there's this battle between Bishop Stanislaw and the king. And it is kind of unclear all what was said, but Stanislaw, he is someone who did not actually want to be bishop in the first place. And he was actually ordered by Pope Alexander II to become bishop, to accept it. And he does it, but he also has the courage to stand up for the divine and to say, hey, listen, King, this is not your territory. Thank you for building all these churches, but you are not in charge of the churches. This is the Catholic Church. And of course, he got murdered for it. And King Boleslaw, he had to find refuge in Hungary after that. But it parallels this battle between the material world, so the secular world, and the church. And it also reminds us of how Thomas Becket, the English martyr, was murdered, or St. Thomas More, this battle between the world and the church, between the divine and the material world. And so it is good stuff for us to pray with. Where am I in this battle? And of course, as always, we have the psalm is usually right in between the readings, kind of giving a balance to it. And today's psalm, Psalm 34, the refrain was, "The Lord hears the cry of the poor." A God also who listens to our cry. And what I really, to sum it up, the last line actually of today's psalm, it says, "Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord rescues them from them all." The Lord will rescue us, and we would not call ourselves righteous, but I would want to rephrase this. All who try to live good lives and place their trust in God, God will rescue them. Now, that rescuing, of course, does not mean that nobody loses their life. It can mean that we lose their life, but we're talking about spiritual rescue. And so it is for us in our daily life too, in our families, at works, to be waiting for God, to be waiting for God. And especially if you're struggling, if there's, say, at work or in the families, and there are things which are happening which we cannot control, which are very not helpful or even scandalous, but to wait for God, a God who will rescue us, And rescue can also very much mean a God who will give us the words to know when to speak, to know when to speak, and to speak like the apostles in Acts. Just speak it freely and even oppose. But it cannot come from ourselves. It has to come from God. God will give us the words when we have to defend ourselves. And it's as simple as that. So it's good stuff to pray with. And where am I in this world, in this journey? Am I more in a material world or the spiritual world? Am I waiting for God to grant me the words when I have to speak? And especially in our families or in the workplaces or wherever we find ourselves. It's this balance. And it's not easy. You cannot learn about it in a book. But it's all about prayer and being still with God who can lead us. Amen. And so let us bring our prayers before the Lord. We pray for all those in our daily TV Mass prayer intention book. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
This Easter season, we offer our community prayer in thanksgiving for the new life that is ours in the risen Christ. May we be strengthened by his healing presence among us, so that we might live in peace and glorify him by our life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
With Pope Francis, we pray that the dignity and immense value of women be recognized in every culture, and for the end of discrimination that they experience in different parts of the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all our political leaders that they will selflessly work for the good of the people who elected them, while being open to the guidance of the Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for these prayers, and the prayers in the silence of our own hearts, we lift them up to you, Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquities. Cleanse me of my sins. Thank you. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good of all and his holy church.
Receive, we pray, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise which we offer to your majesty in commemoration of Blessed Martyr Stanislaw, that it may lead us to obtain pardon and confirm us in perpetual thanksgiving through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders for your might. In your mercy, you give a door to their faith, to their endurance, you grant firm resolve, and in their struggle, the victory is yours, through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the host of angels, cry out, and without end we acclaim.
granteth the full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Francis, our Bishop, the order of bishops, the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And at the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of peace.
take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And may the body of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Safe for eternal life.
Please join me now in this act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in this holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I passionately desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my soul, so that I may unite myself wholly to you, now and forever. Amen.
And let us pray. We have received your heavenly gifts, rejoicing at this feast day, O Lord. Grant, we pray, that we who in this divine banquet proclaim the death of your Son may merit to be partakers with the holy martyrs in his resurrection and in his glory, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our thanks to our donor for the gift of this Mass.
We gather.